A little highlight reel of the life and legacy of goaltending great Johnny Bower, one of the most beloved players to ever wear the blue and white of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Bower died yesterday at the age of 93 after a short battle with pneumonia. I'm joined now by his grandson, John Bower, from just outside Edmonton. Good morning, John.
Good morning.
What are you remembering most about your grandfather today?
Well, first of all, thank you for having me this morning, and thank you for that beautiful clip that just rolled.
Especially yeah, you were hearing smiling. Billy Hewitt. Tell me why you were smiling through it. Tell me what really resonated with you.
Well, because my grandfather had two careers, and the first one was being a hockey player, 25 years in the minors in the American Hockey League, 1 year with the Rangers, and then another 12 with the Maple Leafs. So hearing the clip of him talking about trying to win the Stanley Cup, because that was his dream as a child, was to win the Stanley Cup, idolizing Frankie Brimsek, ironically, of the Boston Bruins, Mr. Zeros. But just hearing Bill Hewitt announce the three stars of the Gardens on Hockey Night in Canada, had a chance to see a lot of the videos in the CBC and the Molson Breweries archives over the years, and it's wonderful to see that and hear that again, because the one thing is that Grandpa will always be living. He's a living legend, even in his passing. And the thing that I've been most thinking of over the last just over 24 or 12 hours now, is how much he touched people with his humbleness, his humility, his humanity, his compassion for others. And the fact that for him, it was more than a game. It was that it came with a responsibility, being a star. And I think he treated others the way that he would have liked to have been treated, coming from a very poor background in Prince Albert, Saskatchewan during the Depression, and a large family, rising to where he did through hockey and being able to use his fame to be able to help others. And I will never forget that he's installed those values in the family.
Oh, for sure. I mean, you were just a kid when he played in the NHL, but what was it like to watch him play?
Well, you know, most of my memories are watching Grandpa either in old-timer games or by watching the videos. And the one thing that hits me about the way that he plays was that he was a much more of a stand-up goaltender than we see today. And he always admired watching Martin Brodeur from the New Jersey Devils, because he felt that he was the closest to his style of a stand-up goaltender, whereas today most goaltenders play the butterfly. So they're down before a lot of shots to be able to see through legs, whereas Grandpa was a much more stand-up goaltender and a very aggressive goaltender, mm-hmm. With the poke check coming out and attacking players. So yeah. That's the difference. The other thing that Grandpa had in him was that this desire to be the best. So he was not the best skilled, most skilled goaltender in the history of the game. But as George Armstrong reminds me on a regular basis, he says that your grandfather was the hardest working man on the ice. He never wanted to give up a goal, even in practice. And he only achieved perfection 37 times in a 552-game NHL career, and those being shutouts.
Yeah, he was scrappy and determined when you watch him in the video clips. But can you tell me about the Leafs, what that team meant to him? And he just dedicated so much time and effort to the team as well.
He's Mr. Maple Leaf. Even in the darkest hours of the 1980s, he always believed in the team, or as he would say, I believe. We said that if you if he cuts himself, he'll bleed blue and white, not red blood. He just always believed in the team, which is ironic because he didn't want to come to Toronto. When he was drafted in the interleague draft in 1958-59 from the Cleveland Barons, he was very content at 34 years of age to remain in Cleveland and the American Hockey League. And it was Jim Hendy, the owner of the Barons, who had to convince him to try out for Toronto, guaranteeing him a job with the Barons if ever it didn't work out with the Maple Leafs. And as we all know, he led the Leafs to the Stanley Cup final in his first two seasons, the first time since the Bill Barilko goal that the Leafs had been in the finals, so about a seven-year absence, and then ultimately helping them win three consecutive Stanley Cup championships from 1962 to 64, and again in 1967 as the Over the Hill Gang.
We've run out of time, John, but I just want to ask really quickly. We heard that Johnny famously kept a bottle of champagne in his fridge, saving it for the next time the Leafs win the Cup. What will happen with that bottle now?
We will open it in his honor when the Leafs win their next Stanley Cup, and hopefully that will be sooner rather than later.
Fantastic. Many condolences to you and your family, but what a legacy your grandpa has left.
Well, thank you to yourself and to the outpouring of support that we've been receiving since late yesterday afternoon when we had to make the unfortunate announcement.
All right. Take care.
Thank you.
John Bauer, the grandson of Johnny Bauer.